This is everything new with Digital Factory 11. And it got better, but really different. First thing you're gonna notice when you update is you should be this kind of dark mode, which is pretty cool. If you do wanna switch back to the old layout, you just click on View to UI mode and Classic. If you're currently in Classic, go to Next Gen and then you have to close it down and restart it. There are a handful of things that make this update awesome. There's also some things that are really frustrating because there's gonna be a lot of things that aren't where you're used to them being, so you might struggle finding them. So I'm gonna show you where those things are at and also show you why this one is so much better. All right, first, let's load some images into our RIP software. Now, sometimes it will dump them down in this job reserve list. I'm not exactly sure why it's doing that. I've tried some different settings to see if I can change that, but they might end up in your job reserve list. Just pull them up into your active window. You'll see them here like you're used to. Couple things. First is any kind of like queue property adjustments. You can do the usual queue properties, go there, or you can just click on these three little dots in the queue tab at the top. And what that's gonna give you is your print mode, your media width, and your layout. And a lot of systems default to auto nest. I personally prefer manual just because it lets me adjust the different graphics before I nest them together. But that's there. And then you've got some other properties here. Your default color adjustment is right here. Let's get into some of the things that I really, really, really love. So first thing, is when you click on the graphic, instead of this window down here, everything's off to the side. And at first it's a little cumbersome trying to figure out where things are at, but basically here's your location, X and Y. You're probably not gonna change that much. This is your size right here. You can either just double click on it and type in your size, or you can click these up and down arrows. You can do height, width. You can unlock the aspect ratio here, though I'm not sure why you would wanna do that. And then if you just want to reset the scale and everything, you can just reset it right there. Here's your rotation and then your crop. And a lot of people haven't used crop before, so I'm going to show you that real quick. This hasn't changed the actual crop window. Once it loads, you can either just click and drag the area you'd like to crop, or you can use these X and Y axes to move the edge of the crop, or you can just click and drag the edges in. So those are all the different ways to crop. Moving on, we have our print mode. So I'm gonna select our current print mode that we're using. You have your normal stuff, your color adjust. You have your mirror, invert, which again, there's a lot of stuff. I'm not sure why you would use them, but that's just the case because CADlink is designed for multiple wide format printers, not just direct to film. Here's where they changed things and made it so much better, the copies. So if I click add copies, it's gonna add a second copy, and instead of it pulling up a separate window, it adds a dropdown. So if you scroll down, you're gonna see here your options to add additional columns to it, or additional rows, additional columns if you want to. It shows you the total number that you're gonna have. It shows your spacing vertically and horizontally between them. Here's what I love about this, is let's say I forgot to do a color adjustment, but I made all my copies. In the previous version, you had to like delete all the copies to be able to color adjust. You can color adjust with all your copies. It's awesome. So if you need to go in there and change your white underbase or something like that, it's just right there. You don't have to cancel your copies. Another thing is if you wanted to delete the copies, cause you're like, oops, I didn't want to make a bunch of copies. You had to go into that copies window on the old version and literally set everything back down to zero. This one, there's a button, remove copies. It's fantastic. Like literally those two things are enough to make it worth the little bit of hassle figuring out the new layout of things. That is by far my favorite feature or adjustment in the new version. So add copies, you get all your options down here, and then you can just remove copies. It is fantastic. A couple other things you'll notice is your page options, your queue options are all right here in the side instead of down below. Again, you can make some adjustments here. Again, for the most part, you should have print modes that you're kind of defaulting to, so I can't imagine you're gonna need to use a whole lot of these adjustment features, but if you're testing, you're definitely gonna utilize those. Also, you've got your queue properties. Again, depending on where you click, it gives you different options. All the things that are on the sidebar were in the lower kind of window on the old version. All that stuff is pretty much there. It's just kind of laid out a little differently. Here you've got, this isn't a print button. A lot of people think it defaults to that. No, it just prints the, it just toggles the print preview visibility. And one last thing, one thing that drove me absolutely bonkers with the old version of CADlink is if I had a really long gang sheet and I wanted to scroll through it, I couldn't scroll. It would always zoom in and out. There's a gear here, and you can uncheck or check the use mouse wheel to zoom. So if that always drove you nuts, just click the gear and make sure use mouse wheel to zoom is unchecked. And that's pretty much it for the updates. Everything else is pretty much the same. Any of your tabs up here at the top, devices, print mode managers, all that kind of stuff is generally gonna look pretty much the same. This is just the part that's changed. And I definitely think for the better. I'm gonna finish putting some copies together. I'm gonna print these out. These are graphics for an upcoming video we're doing, but I appreciate you guys watching. And if you guys have any questions about the new version of CADlink Digital Factory 11, feel free to ask them down in the comments below. We'd love to answer them. If there's a tool that you used to have that you can't find, let us know and we'll see if we can figure out where it's at for you. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.